I never imagined to go to any saint, and I don't believe in anybody except Baba. And if Baba said like that, I'll have a quarrel next day with Baba. And the Mandali, and there was a very fun. So then we went to our residence in Gadge Maharaj Dharamshala, and I told Gupta that from next day we won't wait for him, and he should manage coming to Guru Prasad independently, and we will go to Guru Prasad with our family members. We won't wait for them. So Gupta said that we should have a round in Pune city that day, and next day he will send back to his family. And I say, you do whatever you want to do, but I won't come, I won't accompany, and I won't wait for you from tomorrow. So that day we had arranged to move in Pune city in the evening. But at about 4, Baba sent a message to us, and Baba said that myself and my family members should attend a bhajan program at Pune railway station. So I said, Gupta, see, Baba has ordered this, and now if you want to go to Pune city for round, you can go. I'll go to bhajan. I'll go for bhajan program, and I'll attend according to Baba's orders. And then that person who has come from Baba to give me message, he says, Baba was saying that just an ass, ass is there, and ass goes from one hip to another hip to third hip, and like that he is moving from hip to hip, and you also are doing the same thing after coming to Pune, so you should not go from one hip to another and another to third, and should come to Baba. And I say, this is all false. And if Baba has said, I'll again quarrel with Baba, you are also repeating the same thing, and I'll again quarrel with Baba, I have come here, and I never dreamt to visit any place or to go to any saint. There was a Sindhi saint in Pune, and he said that Baba has said that he might have gone there, and due to that he has delayed to attend the Guru Prasad function. So I said, I never dreamt about it. And then Baba, then next day, when I went to Baba has, very early morning, I was and my family members were the first to attend the Guru Prasad next morning. And when next morning Baba called us, we went inside. And then Baba asked whether you received any message. I said, yes, I received message, and accordingly I obeyed your order, and I had gone for bhajan program to Pune railway station. Then Baba said what he has said, what message was given to you. So I said, Baba, the message given to me was very incorrect, and I never dreamt I come. And Baba has ordered him not to make robbery and stop this business of dacoity, and he has agreed to Baba. But still then he done the same thing. And as soon as he wanted to break open that house, then suddenly he seen Baba there. And then Baba asked him that, you had promised me not to do this thing again, and you are still here. So then he apologized Baba and say he will never do it. When Baba asked him to repeat that, he wept and he said, Baba, why you want to disclose this thing? Baba says, don't worry. So then there were letters from the lady devotees of Baba that Baba is continuously giving their darshan program to male members, and not females are not allowed. So Baba chalked out a program for ladies savas program, and that was to be taken next. And Baba has made declaration that the next program will be for ladies. So male persons of the family, they should not hesitate to be at home and to care for their children, and allow the ladies to come for savas program. Otherwise, they will say, Baba, they had remained, ladies remained at home,
to take care of their children, and again the male persons will be participating in the program. So that program, that Savas program plan was checked out in the Savas program of 1955. Then the people from Arangao, they requested Baba to have worship from Arangao people, and they wanted to take Baba to their village in a chariot. But Baba said he'll walk down and he'll accept their worship. And accordingly, Baba took all the Savasis to that village, and Baba went from home to home and he has accepted the worship. This was the Savas program of 1955. then again, I had a chance to go to Baba. But in the meantime, this Savas program was extended due to Baba's accident. And after accident, Baba had arranged darshan program at Sakuri. So, in circular sent by Baba, it was mentioned Baba will visit Sakuri, Baba will give his darshan at Sakuri ashram for a few hours in the morning. And naturally, those who are desirous to come there, they should visit Sakuri ashram and take Baba's darshan. So, Mr. Pankhraj, who was my colleague, he asked me whether I would like to visit Sakuri program. And I said, because I had booked for the whole family members, I said I won't come this time due to financial stringency, and I didn't went there for that for Baba's darshan at Sakuri. I thought I am just newly in contact of Baba, and there will be a much crowd, and Baba will see somebody, we will be in some corner, and Baba won't be able to see us, Baba won't be able to have a glance at us, and so I have not gone. But when that program was over and my colleague Mr. Pankhraj came back from program, I inquired about that program, and he said Baba was there for the whole day, though he has declared that he will be there for few hours, but he was for the whole day, and Baba had asked everyone to come near to him, and Baba has inquired about everybody. So I was very much upset that I had lost the chance of Baba's darshan. And just I left my meals and all that, I was too much upset for losing the opportunity for Baba's darshan. And suddenly on third day, I have not talked about this to anybody, and suddenly on third day, there was a letter from Baba inquiring about me, why I had not attended the Sakuri program and come to Baba. And not only me, but all the children and my wife too, why they have not come, whether they have forgotten Baba, their beloved, and they should have come to for Sakuri program. But though they have not come, I should not worry for anything, and Baba's presence is there with you. Baba said, my presence is there with you, and you should keep the atmosphere very happy. You should sing Baba's bhajans, all the children should sing Baba's bhajans, and the atmosphere at Mehar Niwas should be a very happy one. So that was my first instance how Baba could read the thoughts of every person, because I had never told this thing to anybody else. And Baba, the thought that came to my mind, Baba could read there, and Baba has replied that letter without any anybody's information. So that was my first experience that I had, that Baba knows everything and Baba is almighty. Then in the year 1958, this Savas program, this was postponed, and it took place in 1958. Before that, there was a meeting, and some persons, Baba has called some persons at Mehrabad to convey his universal message, very limited persons were called from, and from old CP and Berar, we three persons were there. So I had an occasion to be present. From old CP and Berar, we three persons were there. So I had an occasion to be present in that meeting also, and to convey that universal message, Baba's universal message, throughout this area. Then in 1958, this Savas program for all our family members, we went there at Mehrabad, and there was a binding from Baba, there was a circular that the members who are below 13 years, 13 or 17 like that, they will not be allowed to participate in the Savas program. And there was difficulty before me, because all these children, my children, they were below 13. But I had a staunch desire that they should also participate and they should be in Savas program. So I had gone earlier, and I had hired a house there in Arangav village, and I had arranged a dai for taking care of the children, and we too, myself and my wife, we had our seats there in the program pendal, and we had attended that program. So in the 1958 program, when we reached there, a wooden pinjara, it was lying at Baba's dhuni, and we never knew that it is of some importance. We thought it might be a wooden and it is lying there. So this Meera was only 3 months child. So we arranged her cradle by rope in that pinjara, and she used to be in that cradle there. So on the first day when we attended that program, then my son Dilip, he wrote a letter. He will describe his experience later on. He wrote a letter to Baba. Then we participated in that program for 1 week. And then for another group also, Hindi Gujarati group also, Baba has asked us, and Baba has permitted us to stay there and to participate in that program also. So we were there for another program also. And like this, we were there for a period of near about 3 weeks in Baba's Savas. And we enjoyed his Savas. Baba has played with us. Baba has served meals to us, and all that. So one instance is that my sister-in-law, she was with us. She was ill. When we booked for her, her name for program, she was all right. But the program was extended, and then she fell ill. So when she fell ill, she was actually not able to move even from bed. Her feet and hands and her body was completely swollen, and she was unable to move. But we took her to Baba's program, and when we were participant in that program, she rather recovered till the program was over. She used to get up, and she used to sit in the pendal first, and she attended the program like that. So in that program, there were special trains, special platform was managed at Mehrabad Hill, and Baba told that this is the first instance in the history of India that even though there is not a flag station, special trains, the telephone was tapped, telephone arrangements were made, and special trains were stopped there, and special trains were left from there for all the participants of the Savas program. Now I will tell you how Baba takes care of our children. So Baba takes more care of our children than us. All the three children, when they were staying at Dhuni, one day when program was going on in the pendal, and Dhuni was quite away from the pendal, so Baba asked me to stand up, and Baba asked me, where are the children? So I was rather afraid that the children might have come inside and they might be doing some nuisance to the management. So I was rather afraid. But I stood up and told Baba, Baba, they are at Dhuni. They might be in Arangav village or they might be at Dhuni. And Baba then asked as to who is looking after them and who is taking care. So I told Baba that one Dai is kept for their upkeep and she is taking their care. So Baba says she is not attending properly, and those children, they are just peeping into the well, and that well is broken, and it is every possibility that they might fall into the well. So though Baba was attending that Savas program, Baba was looking to all other things also. So that is one instance that how Baba takes care of all his children.
So in 1959, Baba has asked me to be present at Guru Prasad at Pune with my family members only. And there was my friend, Mr. Gupta, and he also wished that he should also accompany us. So I thought he was just like our family members, and I thought that there won't be any harm to allow him to accompany with me and his family members also. So when we went to Pune, and our arrangements were made in Gadge Maharaj Dharamsala, and we accommodated there. Harm to allow him to accompany with me and his family members also. So when we went to Pune, our arrangements were made in Gadge Maharaj Dharamsala, and we accommodated there. And in the night, there was a message from Baba that I should attend Guru Prasad with my family members only on next day. So I asked the person who brought that message to me. I had some other family members also, and whether I should bring them to Guru Prasad or not. So he said Baba had told specifically that those family, you and your family members are to attend the Guru Prasad only. And if you want to bring those family members, then I should take Baba's permission. So next day, we went to Guru Prasad, and Baba called us and our family members also. And along with that Gupta family, they also came to Guru Prasad along with us. So Baba questioned regarding their presence. So I said, Baba, they also love you and they had accompanied with us. Then Baba smiled only. And what happened next day, a time was given to us by Baba, and the family members of Gupta, they were not interested in Baba's darshan because they were not so much loving Baba. That Gupta himself was loving, but those family members, they were not loving Baba. So they were not so curious and not in a hurry, and due to them, we were delayed in attending Guru Prasad, Bangalore, and Baba called us and three times. And then Baba inquired ki why I have not gone there with the Mandali members, and then Baba was rather annoyed. So that day we reached Guru Prasad at about 10, and Baba told the Mandali members that if I attend that Guru Prasad, I should be asked to go out. And just Baba was out in the veranda from that room, and Baba was going. So I just went there with my family members, and I just stood aside, and Baba simply smiled, and Baba went to his hall. Then all the Mandali members, they were asking me why I was not in time, and I had not attended the program. Baba was very much annoyed. Baba said that he is coming from such a long distance with all his family members. He is incurring so much expenditure. He loves me. He is doing my job there. so nicely, and why he has not attended the Guru Prasad in the morning when that specific time was given to me. And then those Mandali members, they told me that Baba had just guessed that I might have gone to some other saint or some other place to see him or to have his darshan there. So I said, I never dreamt or I never imagined to go to any saint. So I said, Baba, the message given to me was very incorrect and I never dreamt. I come here only for your darshan and for your sevas, and then I never believe in anybody, and I don't wish to go, I never dreamt going to any place except then Guru Prasad. So Baba said, what this fellow has told. So I repeated the same thing, just as an ass. As is going from one place to another, one hip to another to third, you are also going to same place. Then Baba said, whether he has told like this? I said, yes, Baba, he has conveyed me this message. Then Baba called that fellow there and he asked him to repeat the message. Baba asked him whether the things I repeated were correct, and he said yes. Then Baba told him ki, I had asked you thrice whether correctly got the message to be conveyed to him, and you said yes, and you have told him incorrect message. Due to this, how his heart has been touched and how he is pained. So you know how his family members, they are having a work at Nagpur, and he is spreading my messages from how long he is coming with what difficulties, and how you have told this incorrect message. So then Baba asked him to, Baba just pinched his ear, and Baba has ordered him to bow down and put his nose to before Baba, and it ended there. So this was the story. Then next day, in afternoon also, Baba ordered me to be there in Guru Prasad Bangalore, and Baba has allowed us to attend the afternoon program also. Third day, Baba asked us to come with him for house visits. Baba was having house visits in Pune for his lovers, at the residence of his lovers. And Baba has taken one day with him in his car for house visits. And when at one place I had accompanied Baba, then there was the house was small and there was too much rush. So I purposely kept myself aloof and I didn't enter that room where Baba was sitting. So Baba, with the idea that Baba may not be inconvenienced and people may not be inconvenienced. So when that worship was started, Baba remembered me and Baba ordered somebody to bring me inside. And Baba asked me to stand by his side and to watch the function there. So this is how Baba was keeping his lovers with them, to just get them idea of Baba's love, Baba's worship, like that. So I think. Then third day Baba asked us in the afternoon to be with him. And Baba has taken us around, and Baba has showed us his college where he was taking education and with him. And Baba has taken us around, and Baba has showed us his college where he was taking education and the places where he was having visits and sitting in the evening time. Then Baba asked me whether I had shown that Bund Garden to my family members. So I said, Baba, no, I am not getting any time, because in the morning also I am with you and in the afternoon also I am with you. So I don't get any time to bring them to Bund Garden. So Baba said, you are fool. When you come to Guru Prasad, you should come with your meals, tiffin, and when that program is over, you should take your family members to Bund Garden, and you should have a lunch there. Then those people, they will go back to their residence and you attend my function. Like that, Baba was taking care of family members also, their their convenience also and all these things. So when you stick up to Baba's orders, you stick up to Baba's discipline, then Baba himself takes care of your family members as well as you. So in 1960, when we went there for Baba's darshan, so that we were allowed for 9 or 10 days, something like that. And after I reached Pune, I had some fever and I could not book my reservation for Nagpur back. And then when that program was over, Baba asked everybody, when are you leaving, when are you leaving? And Baba asked me also. So I said, it was most probably 13th. And I said, Baba, I am leaving on 13th. So Baba said, why are you staying here for 3 days more? You won't be allowed any darshan this day. And you should not come to Guru Prasad site at all. So I said, Baba, I won't. Then Baba said, then what we'll do here for 3 days? So I said, Baba, I was having fever and so I could not attend. I could not attend railway station and I cannot attend railway station and I could not have any reservation for me. So Baba said, why you have not told me? I would have arranged for your reservation. All right, then you be here. And I was just staying one bungalow after Guru Prasad. So Baba said, though you will be staying here, you should not come to Guru Prasad for 3 days. And you should go direct from here to railway station on 13th. I said, yes, Baba, I'll obey your order. So when that day came, when it was our departure day has come, so for these 3 days we never gone to Guru Prasad nor to that site, Guru Prasad site. And just before leaving Pune, one day before, Baba sent his nephew to us, asking them that I should attend Guru Prasad tomorrow morning, the day after that day. And we should come prepared with aarti and puja, because my missus has done one aarti, composed one aarti, and she wanted to have that aarti with Baba. She had a chance once to have Baba's aarti, and she was desiring that a further more chance should be given. So Baba knew her desire, and when though we didn't go to that site for 3 days, Baba himself has sent for us to attend Guru Prasad Bangalore, and Baba with a view to worship him and to have his aarti. And then Baba has allowed us, Baba has asked my wife to have his aarti, which was composed by her, and we had that aarti there. That's all.
Yes. So, in 1958 Savas program, Baba has declared there on the in the pendal, Savas pendal, that whenever his program takes place, all his five perfect masters, they are present there for all the time. And accordingly, this question was raised because somebody asked Baba where they should whether they should go to Sakori or they should go to Shirdi while returning to Nagpur or returning to their respective places after finishing Baba's program. So Baba said, you should not be like a businessman. When you come here, you should come here for my purpose only, because I am doing some sanskars. And if you go from one place to another, another place to third place, then those sanskars, they are divided. And you could not give benefit of those sanskars to your family members. So if you want to go, if you want to attend this for my sake, then you should go direct from here to your residence. And if you want to attend Shirdi or Sakori or some other place, then you should
go back there after going back to your residence, then you start for that place. And then Baba repeated, wherever my program takes place, all the five perfect masters are present. So I experienced this in Baba's birthday celebrations in the year 1961. So what happened, we had a poor feeding program in Baba's birthday celebrations at my place in Bijlinagar. I was staying there at that time. And one fakir from Tajbagh, he had attended there in Tajbagh. So he had, from Tajbagh, he has attended Baba's program. So Baba's hall where the, from Tajbagh, he has attended Baba's program. So Baba's hall where the, all the Baba's photo and all the decoration was made, it was inside. And this poor feeding program was arranged outside the hall. So Baba's one photo was also kept outside. And those who are desirous, so they were allowed to come inside hall and have Baba's darshan. So one of our colleagues, he just went to that fakir, and he was rather pressing him to come to that hall inside and have his darshan there. And he was denying. He said he don't want to bow down, or he don't want to have darshan of any Baba except Tajuddin Baba. So they were just quarreling between themselves, and I just noticed that they are quarreling. So I ran down to them, and I separated them, both of them, and I just told that fakir from Tajbagh that he should not worry, and it is not compulsory on him to come to the hall and see and have a darshan of Mehr Baba. But if he loves Tajuddin Baba, he will have Tajuddin Baba's darshan here. And this has been repeated by Avatar Mehr Baba, that wherever his function takes place, all the five perfect masters, they are present. They are present physically, and their physical presence is there in his program. So, saying this, he asked me whether this is a real. I said, this is not my version. This is Mehr Baba's version, Avatar Mehr Baba's version. And he has declared it in the presence of so many persons at Mehrabad. And then he agreed to come to the hall, and when he stepped in the door of that hall, and he just started weeping, and he said, the thing which you told me, it is true, and I saw Tajuddin Baba here in physical form, and you just give your blessings to me. I said, that is not my authority, I never told you of my own, and this is the version. This is Baba's version, I have repeated, and you are to experience it. So once again, also, one fakir was who was loving Tajuddin Baba. He attended Mehr Baba's function at our place in the night at 10 o'clock. And after sitting for some time, then he began to weep. I said, why you are weeping? So he said, I am seeing here Tajuddin Baba. So I said, this all his perfect masters, all five, he is one of the five perfect masters, and his physical presence is experienced here. So he has also realized that thing, Tajuddin Baba's presence in our Mehr Baba's function. That's all.
My name is Dilip Sadashiv Lokhande. I am quite fortunate enough to have the Baba's darshan at the age of 7 years only. When Baba had come to Nagpur in the year 1953. Then after that, the Sahabat.
My name is Dilip Sadashiv Lokhande. I am quite fortunate enough to have the Baba's darshan at the age of 7 years only. When Baba had come to Nagpur in the year 1953. Then after that, the Sahabat program was held at Ahmednagar in 1958. But in that program, the children were not allowed to participate in the program. At that time, myself, I was 10 years old. My younger brother, Abhay, and sister, Jyoti, and another sister, Meera, she was only 3 months old at that time. So we all went to that Ahmednagar, even if we were not allowed to participate in the program. So we used to stay there on the dhuni. One wooden cage was kept on that dhuni. where Baba had spent so many days in the seclusion. So one day Baba, while going back to Pimpalgaon after finishing the program at Ahmednagar, so we said Avtar Mehru Baba ki jai. So Baba stopped their car there and meet us. Then one day Baba, while coming to attend the program, means before starting the program at Ahmednagar, he asked us, what do you want? So I said that Baba, we want to attend that program. So after some time Baba has sent a message to that Dhuni asking us to attend that program in the Pendal. Then Baba asked, what do you want? So I said, Baba, we want to sing a bhajan. Then Baba allowed us to sing a bhajan. Then at that time, we, that means myself, my younger brother Abhay, and his sister Jyoti, we all went to that pendal and sang a bhajan there. After that, in 1960, I also had that opportunity to see Baba at Pune. And after that, in 1965 also, I had taken the chance to see the Baba. That's all.
Yes. So in 1958 Savas program, my children, they were all below 13 age group, and they were not allowed to participate in the Baba Savas program. So there be staying at Dhuni, just that was the limit of program, and the pendal was inside. So on the first day, my son Dilip, he expressed his desire. And he said that Baba has written a letter that Baba will visit our place and sing and hear the bhajans performed by them. But since Baba has not come and sing and hear the bhajans performed by them, but since Baba has not come and now there is no chance for them to go inside and give their bhajan program to Baba. So he wrote a letter to Baba saying that as per Baba's orders, we are not allowed to enter in the prima and in the pendal program. He was not allowed to attend program inside the pendal since he was below age group 13. So he said, he wrote a letter to Baba. Baba is having limitations to allow them, but they are not having limitations to come to Baba in their limits, that means in their boundary, that is Dhuni. And then Baba has sent a message for me that ask your children to be at Dhuni at about 5, and after the program is over, then Baba will attend at Dhuni and Baba will listen to the bhajans sung by the children. And then Baba took his car after finishing the program at Mehrabad Hills, Lower Mehrabad. Baba took his car to Mehrajat side and suddenly changed the direction and brought his car near Dhuni. And he just taken these children with him and asked them to repeat the bhajans, and Baba has then attended 3 bhajans sung by them, and like that Baba has given them savas. Yes. So in 1961 we went to Baba. As per Baba's orders, we, all the family members, we went to Pune, and we were to attend the function at Guru Prasad, program at Baba's birthday program at Guru Prasad. So on the first day, when we started for Guru Prasad, we purchased some garlands for each family members to be given to Baba. And then when we reached Guru Prasad, we arranged a queue of all our family members. And I have given each garland to each of my family members. This my elder son, this. So I had given him a garland also. And when his turn, everybody went inside and Baba was just sitting like this in the middle and everybody garlanded him. And after garlanding Baba, everybody has taken his seat. When his number was there to garland Baba, he had just gone to Baba about 3 or 4 feet away. And he has thrown away that garland. He has not garlanded Baba. He has thrown away that garland in a corner. And he went away and he sat there in the hall. The hall. Then Baba asked me what has happened to him. So till that time, I never told Baba regarding that, regarding him. He was so furious. Before this, he was so furious. But I never complained Baba and never asked Baba's help in this regard. Because I was having belief, Baba knows everything, so I should not tell anything to Baba. And since 1953, my colleagues were telling me that I should report the matter to Baba and I should seek his help for his improvement. And I said, Baba knows everything, so I should not tell Baba anything. Baba knows everything, and whenever a chance will come, Baba will do whatever Baba wants to do. And I was having this belief. So I never told Baba. So in 1961, when he threw away that garland, he has not garlanded Baba, and he threw away. Before this, he was becoming too furious in the house when I was out of house, and he was not controlled by anybody except me. So he used to tear the cloths, new cloths. He used to throw away the things outside the house. And he used to throw away knives, anything, whatever comes to his hand. And he used to throw away to any family members. So I never told this to Baba. But Baba then asked, when he has not garlanded Baba and he has thrown away that garland, Baba asked me what is wrong with him. And then I narrated the whole story. So Baba told me that I should remember Baba on the coming Sunday and Baba will do his work in his respect. So when that Sunday, but then what happened that day? We returned back to our residence. And when on next day, when we started for Guru Prasad, and when we came to that shop where garlands, from where we had purchased our garlands first day, when we come to that shop, he asked me, he wanted that garland to be purchased for Baba. He himself has asked me that I should purchase a garland from him. I had purchased a garland, I had given it to him. And when we reached Guru Prasad, he himself went inside the hall without calling for Baba, and without Baba has called us, he himself gone inside and he has garlanded on his own accord to Baba. Then on that, when Baba has asked me to remind him on Sunday, so on Sunday I had reminded Baba that, Baba, you had asked me to remind you for something. So Baba said, I have finished my work on the very day. And then I could know that was the effect of Baba's work, that next day while coming, he himself has asked me to purchase a garland for him and he has garlanded Baba. So this is the Baba's working. This is one of the way in which Baba works and in which Baba cares for us. So we are not to repeat anything to Baba, we are not to complain anything to Baba, and I have never complained anything to Baba. That's all. Yes. So, we were just going to Pune for Baba's darshan. And at this time we had taken another route via Kalyan. We had booked our passage via Kalyan, and at Kalyan we were to change. I think this is most probably during the year 1962. So, at Kalyan station we were to change for Pune, and I just got down our all luggage and all that, and I was just busy to change the train and arranging for keeping the kit, other person's kit inside, and our own luggage, it was left on the platform and the train started. So I asked my children, so I had arranged this elder son, I had already got him inside one compartment, and then I run down to for these two children and luggage, and I just asked them to throw the luggage inside whatever compartment is there, and in first class compartment we have thrown our luggage and pushed all these fellows inside. So subsequently what happened, somebody from the compartment, he has pushed him down and his leg was completely cast, and blood was coming, and I have pushed him also inside the first class compartment, and then I entered the compartment. So what happened, as soon as he was pushed out in the compartment, somebody has came from cabin of that first class. There are small compartments, so somebody has come outside and he has taken this fellow inside his compartment. And he has well nourished him and had a bandage and all the medical aid, whatever was necessary, he has done to this. And I was astonished ke how it was done. So this is Baba's love, Baba's care. How he cares for us. Because I never dreamt that there will be a doctor and he'll take care of this fellow there. But actually he came out. Suddenly, as soon as he was pushed, he came out. And then he has taken him inside, and without our asking us, without our knowledge, he has suddenly taken him inside. He has washed his wound and he has dressed, and then he was again...
My name is Lakshmi Narayan, and when I was nearly about 6 to 7 years old, I used to go to Hindi school at Dharampet with my younger brother named Muniraj. So I remember it twice. Tajuddin Baba used to go to Telangkheri. Yes, Tajuddin Baba used to go to Telangkheri daily in the morning. But sometime on Saturday, there.
That time remembers, I cannot forget, you see. And somebody, my mother, sister, wife, brother, all were on the well foundation. I was down in the well and I was going to the end of my life there. But nobody can save me. And not only my mother, sister, or brother, but even nearly about 200 to 300 people were there. But nobody wanted to jump into the well because they say that if you caught hold of us, then we cannot be saved there. Nobody can be saved from you there. So at last, someone has thrown a rope or bundle into the well. So one end was with him and another end. When I was gone down, then the bundle was gone that side and one rope end was come to me. So I caught that another rope end. So he was lifting the rope that side and I was lifting the rope inside. So bundle took nearly about 1 to 2 or 2 to 2.5 minutes to open that fully. So that time, till that time I was there, I don't want to leave that rope. So at last I come up and he was taken me up. So after that I went to the Baba after some time. I wrote a letter Baba also. After some time I went to the Baba and told all story. The Baba told me, you had jumped there without calling me or without remembering me. If you had remembered me and you have called me there while jumping, you would have saved that girl also. After meeting such accident or anything in this instance, then everybody calls me. But before that, nobody calls me. And nobody remembers me. That's all. When I cannot manage to save myself and save to the girl, so I left the girl. The girl has gone down. And it was the task myself to how to come up. So I had gone first time to the well. down. Then I remember Baba, and Baba, you can only save me. Everybody is here, no one can save me. Then again I come up, and again I gone down. When I know that if I can control the breath, then something will happen. Till the breath is there, nothing will be happen to me. Then again, when third time I come up, so then I have seen everything, but I remembering Baba every time. Baba, now help me, help me, help me. Then when I gone the third time in the down, then one rope has come, rope bundle has come to the well, and one end to me and one end to the top. And the rope bundle has took nearly two and a half minutes to open that bundle, and then I used to come up.
This is a letter dated, my name is Sadashiv Lakshman Rao Lokhande. This is a letter from Bhav Kalchuri, narrated by beloved Baba. This letter is dated 13-2-1960.
Bhav Kalchuri, narrated by beloved Baba. This letter is dated 13-2-1968. The contents are as follows. Your letter dated 10th February along with birthday programs received. It was read out to beloved Baba, due to which he was pleased with you very much. Baba wish you all to be fully concentrated in arranging the programs of birthday celebrations and not to worry for anything. Baba is with you, and by his nazar, means glance, all the programs will be successful. You and all the family members are very much liked and loved by Baba, and he knows that a very high place has been created for him in your heart. Baba is always existing in your infinite heart, and your very existence is his love. Due to this only, his intensive nazar, means glance, is always on you. A letter dated 17th January 68 was a signal for you to be drowned yourself in Baba's deep love flames. You should not think over it at all, as you are Baba's gem, to whom he is always keeping in front of his nazar, means glance, and from that nazar, this gem is getting Baba's attraction. Your heart is full of nectar, and a fountain of nectar is rightly flowing to you from Baba. You are Baba's beloved son, and his lap is for you. Baba wish that you should flow a fountain of nectar in Nagpur this year, so that people could drink plenty of nectar in his programs and awake themselves in respect of Baba. Baba is with you. Baba is pleased with you very much, and sends his love to you, Sister Vijaya, Chandra, Dilip, Abhay, and Meher Jyoti, and sends his loving kiss to beloved Meera. So I am telling you the story how Baba was with me on 29th January 1969, two days before dropping off his body. So only this construction was here, and main construction was not in existence. So we were in hurry of arranging Baba's birthday programs, and just I returned from office, and just I was to manage some letters and drop some letters to Honorable Jagjivan Ram, who was then Defense Minister of India. Then I just told my wife that she should prepare food, and I'll take my food, and then I'll start for the program. But after some time, when I came out, I had just a shivering, and I thought that I'll suffer from fever. And then I went inside, and I thought that I'll suffer from fever. And then I went inside. Then again, after 10 or 15 minutes, I came out, and I just tried whether I'm all right or I'll be able to go out or I'll suffer more. So I feel again shivering come to me, and I feel that I'll suffer from fever. And so I told my wife that I won't take my meals, and I then lie down and I went to sleep at about 7:30. Then, now I'll do. I just got shivering and I thought I am suffering from fever. And then I came back inside and I lie down on my bed and I told my wife that I won't take any meals and I am suffering from fever. And then I just lie down on my bed and I just slept. So at about 9:30, I was just, somebody touched my head and I was just awakened. So I thought, my wife is awakening me to take medicines for fever. So I was just shivering and I thought I am suffering shivering and I thought I am suffering from fever. And then I went inside. I went inside and just lie down on the bed. So I just came inside and I lie down on my bed or here and I went asleep. So at about 9:30, somebody came here and touched my head and awakened me. So I thought my wife has come to me and she is awakening me for getting some medicines for fever. So I just awoke and just I saw, but my wife and children, they were all asleep. So I just came out and I saw as to who is there, but there was nobody. So I again came inside and I lie down and I was just looking to the roof as to what has happened and who has awakened me, but there was nobody. Just after a minute or two, Baba just came inside, and when I saw Baba coming to me, I got up. So Baba said, "You don't worry, you don't get up, you just lie down because you are having fever." And then Baba sat near me to my head, and Baba has taken my head on his knees, on his thigh. And just Baba was moving his hand on my face and Baba was just loving me. So I said, "Baba, I just shifted here a month before. This is a new area to me and I have just arranged the birthday celebrations. I have just invited our Honorable Jagjivan Ram, who is Defense Minister of India. And this program should be a successful one. And there should not be any trouble in program." So Baba said, "Don't worry, everything will happen as usual and your program will be a success." So I said, "Baba, I'll awake my wife and children. Will happen as usual and your program will be a success." So I said, "Baba, I'll awake my wife and children and we will have a bhajan and aarti and you take milk and then go." So Baba was just going. So I say, "Baba, you have come here after two years and now you are going so soon. So please wait and just please wait and have milk and aarti and then go." Then Baba asked me, Baba said, "If you promise me not to awaken your family members, then I'll be with you." And I said, "Baba, whatever you order, I'll obey your orders." So then Baba again sat on my bed and just Baba was loving me by moving his hand over my face. And Baba was with me for about 2 to 3 hours. Then Baba said that I have finished my work and now I'll go. So I said, just Baba was with me for about 2.5 hours, and just at about 12, Baba got up from my bed and just Baba said, "Now my work is over and I'll leave this place." So I said, "Baba, I'll awake my family members and we will have a aarti and you just have a milk and then you go." So Baba said, "You have given me a promise not to awake your family members." So I said, "Baba, I'll keep up my promise. I won't disobey." And then Baba came out of the room and I also followed Baba just to the door. Just. So Baba came out of the room saying that his work has been finished. He has finished his work. And then I also followed Baba and I also came out of the room. Then I was just saying, Baba, Baba, you have come after so many days and you are going like that without having your aarti and without having taken any milk and all that. So I was just looking to Baba and I was rather sorry that Baba is going without taking milk and without taking any aarti and hearing bhajans. So Baba said, you have promised not to awaken any of your family members. So I said, Baba, I have promised, but if you allow, I will awake them. Otherwise, I won't disobey your orders. So just I was saying this thing and Baba was just having round one stroll, two stroll, three strolls. And just in the meantime, my wife, however, awoke and just she came behind me and she was asking me as to whom I am watching so late hours and what I am seeing outside this. So just I thought if I look to her, Baba will miss. And thinking this, I was just looking to Baba and just then I turned my eyes a very little and when I saw in front of me, Baba disappeared.